I kind of come on live with Ellie Setback reporting. Why is it not on? Oh, yeah, it's working.
Hello?
Ellie, what's going on?
What's
Mr.
up,
Ellie?
Amir? How you
we
feeling?
We are chilling. I'm all right, man. I'm good, but I'm getting a bit bored, man. It's a little bit hard, you know. I've got my own gym, but I'm not been going there. I've been doing some training at home. And believe it or not, just before I this all started, all this pandemic corona thing started, I moved all my machines to the gym. I had like a big gym at home. And the reason I moved it was all converted down. So it's going to be like a plan like this. It's going to be like open. I mean, so I live in most of my. I'm lying and everything. So, yeah. How's everything in LA?
Here, I'll show you. I'm here in LA. Hey, look at this. This is in Beverly Hills right now. A lot of people just a park over here. Everybody's going for a walk. It's a beautiful day with temperature, but it's covered here. So, that's good.
Yeah, which is good. Yeah, what's the temperature there?
25, 28.
Oh, 70s. I think not. 70s. Yeah, that's not bad. 70s is cool.
But you know what's crazy, Amir? I'll tell you what's funny. About 2 weeks ago, everybody does articles. How are you going? And now you're getting calls from Al Heyman. You're getting calls from Bob Arum. Eddie Hearn has you on his live. Everybody wants you to fight.
Bro, I've been very fortunate, Ellie, that I've always sold tickets and been a big ticket seller. TV, like my fights, they're easy. But I'm going to announce something. If this virus ends, I'm going to announce something big. And I want to have you on board in when I give you that story. You know what I mean? I want to send it to you first. But it's going to be massive. I mean, I'm looking at all the other avenues I want to do in boxing. So what's the name? I've got the connection with TV. I've got the connection with all the other promoters and fights and fighters, etc. You know, so I want to take boxing to a different level. I've got the power to do it, man. So why not try it?
Yeah. Now, by the way, I want to share something with you about 2 weeks ago. And he wanted to give away money to 10 families to feed them. 10 families. We ended up helping 100 families.
Wow.
And I can't tell you how much work it was every day, hours and hours to get their information. I'm thinking Amir helped 10,000. How did you do that? I had 100. Very hard. People, sometimes they'll give you information. Sometimes my facing people. I'm like, help.
Charity, mine's 100% charity, where you give $1 will go to the poor people. Whereas there's other organizations out there which are very renowned and very big charities to take a massive administration fee. Now, if I was going to give say £50,000 to a charity, bro, I think only 25 is going to hit the people.
Well,
you know, and it's
slow. I'm going to shock you. In the United States, you can keep up to 90. So if Amir Khan donates $100 to a charity, they could keep 98%. 100%. I looked it up. I looked it up because I've had like orphanages want help to promote stuff. And a good rating is if they keep 84%. That's very high, 84%.
I see mine's 100%. And believe it or not, like even the administrator, I mean, even the gifted, we get gifted. So every time you, whatever you get back, you get 25% from the government. Even that, I throw that back in again. It's costing me to charity because at the end of the day, I'm paying the money at my own. So that way they do it. They look to God and say, but charity business to me.